In his most recent appearance, Pierre made sure to bring the heat to Justin Trudeau's topics. The 8-year tenure of Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has become the focal point for Pierre Poilievre's scrutiny as he directs attention towards several critical issues that have unfolded under Trudeau's leadership. With his plummeting polls and lack of public support, it seems that Trudeau is going to have a hard time gaining voters come election time. As Trudeau faces plummeting polls and a noticeable lack of public support, one cannot help but wonder, can Trudeau effectively address the concerns that have led to this decline in popularity? Welcome back to Street Politics Canada. In his typical fashion, Pierre Poilievre appeared on CP24 to comment on Trudeau's costly policies. From the carbon tax to high interest rates, Poilievre made sure to not hold back and bear it all.
I want to shift the topic to Canada's finances, unemployment, which has now ticked up to 5.8%. We're dealing with an affordability crisis, food insecurity. More people are visiting food banks. How do you address all of this? I mean, these are mounting issues that are affecting so many people. It doesn't seem like there's one quick fix to this issue.
No, unfortunately, it took Justin Trudeau 8 years to cause this problem. He has brought in a carbon tax, which drives up the cost of our farmers and truckers that bring us our food. His inflationary spending, which has doubled the debt, has caused housing and other prices to rise at the fastest level in 40 years. And now, of course, everyone's being hit with the interest rate hikes he promised would never happen. So my common sense plan to bring home lower prices is to axe the carbon tax. That'll bring down heat, gas, and grocery bills. We'll cap spending and cut waste to balance the budget so that we can bring down interest rates and inflation. We'll lower income tax so that hard work pays off again. You bring home more of each dollar you earn. And we'll clear away the bureaucracy to build affordable homes.
Among these pressing concerns, Poilievre emphasizes Trudeau's approach to environmental policies, particularly the implementation of this costly carbon tax. This contentious policy, aimed at mitigating climate change, has drawn Poilievre's criticism for its devastating impact on Canadian families, who are already struggling amid inflation, high interest rates, and a soaring housing crisis. In addition to environmental policies, Poilievre raises the alarm on food insecurity, pointing to a growing problem that has become more pronounced during Trudeau's time in office. The policies enacted under Trudeau's leadership have failed to adequately address the fundamental issue of ensuring a secure and affordable food supply for Canadians. Food insecurity, a critical aspect of national well-being, has become a key point of contention in Poilievre's critique. Furthermore, Poilievre directs his scrutiny towards Trudeau's inflationary spending practices. The accumulation of government expenditures, often fueled by expansive fiscal policies, has become a source of concern for conservatives like Poilievre, as well as many Canadians. Such inflationary spending might be contributing to economic challenges, which in turn has Canadians questioning the sustainability of the financial decisions made during Trudeau's time in office. The mounting housing crisis is another issue that Poilievre places squarely on Trudeau's shoulders. As housing affordability continues to deteriorate, Poilievre argues that the policies implemented by the Trudeau government have not effectively addressed the root causes of the crisis. The shortage of affordable housing options and the subsequent impact on Canadians seeking stable living conditions represent a critical failure that Poilievre attributes to Trudeau's leadership. In essence, Poilievre's pressure on Trudeau encapsulates a comprehensive critique of the economic, environmental, and social policies implemented during the Prime Minister's 8-year term. By focusing on the carbon tax, food insecurity, inflationary spending, and the housing crisis, Poilievre aims to highlight what he perceives as the inadequacies and failures of Trudeau's governance in these key areas. After 8 years of Justin Trudeau, it seems that it's pretty obvious that he is not worth the cost. The political landscape in Canada has become increasingly heated as Pierre Poilievre, a prominent conservative figure, takes center stage in pressuring Prime Minister Justin Trudeau on a myriad of issues. However, is Poilievre justified in his criticisms, or is he just another politician looking to rile up the current head of state in an attempt to rise in the ranks? Trudeau's carbon tax policies, inflationary spending, the housing crisis, public safety failures, gun control measures, and an unexpected pivot towards the Global Security Reporting Program can all be considered valid concerns for any Canadian. Pierre Poilievre's recent appearances have been marked by a fervent critique of Justin Trudeau's carbon tax policies. Over the course of 8 years, Trudeau's approach to environmental issues has faced increasing scrutiny. Poilievre underscores the economic implications of the carbon tax, arguing that it has adversely affected investment per worker in Canada compared to the U.S. A critical analysis of the chart reveals a stark divergence coinciding with Trudeau's election 8 years ago, emphasizing the economic consequences of his policies. Beyond environmental policies, Poilievre extends his criticism to Trudeau's inflationary spending and the escalating housing crisis. These issues, intertwined with the broader economic landscape, have direct repercussions on the lives of everyday Canadians. This emphasizes the need to explore the tangible impact of Trudeau's policies on food insecurity and the housing crisis, highlighting the struggles faced by citizens as they contend with rising costs of living and a shortage of affordable housing options. The script transitions to the realm of public safety, where Poilievre points to what he perceives as a significant failure under Trudeau's leadership. Statistics reveal alarming trends in total violent crimes over the past 8 years. Homicides, gang-related incidents, violent gun crimes, and other offenses have experienced significant spikes, prompting Poilievre to question the effectiveness of the Liberal response. The proposed gun control measures are quite interesting to say the least, considering the fact that they target law-abiding citizens without addressing the root causes of the escalating crime rates. A closer examination of the Liberal government's gun control policies follows, with Poilievre asserting that the focus on law-abiding citizens fails to address the core problems. The banning of sport rifles, attempts to ban hunting rifles, and proposed magazine bans draw criticism from Poilievre, who contends that these measures are misguided. The unexpected inclusion of insights from former National Security Advisor Richard Fadden sheds light on diplomats allegedly overstepping their authority, raising concerns about the transparency and accountability of Canadian intelligence programs. Now, considering the Global Security Reporting Program, which is an international intelligence initiative, Poilievre questions the transparency and accountability of the program, citing incidents where diplomats may have exceeded their authority. Insights from Richard Fadden, who served as the director of the Canadian Security Intelligence Service, add weight to concerns about the GSRP's operations. It's important to note the potential consequences of interactions with GSRP officers, referencing individuals detained in foreign countries, and calls for a thorough examination of the program's engagement with contacts and sources. Examining the organizational structure of the GSRP program within global affairs, the script probes whether adequate oversight exists. Former senior policy analyst Peter Jones suggests that concerns raised by individuals detained in foreign countries after interacting with GSRP officers warrant a closer look at the program's engagement with contacts and sources. The delay in releasing the 2020 report on GSRP by the National Security and Intelligence Review Agency raises questions about transparency and accountability. Many are advocating for a thorough examination of the GSRP program and call for transparency in its operations. In conclusion, Pierre Poilievre's sustained pressure on Justin Trudeau covers a spectrum of critical issues, ranging from economic policies to public safety and international intelligence programs. All of these aspects provide insight and perspective on the shortcomings of Trudeau's leadership, while offering insightful analysis into the challenges facing Canada under his governance. As the political stage in Canada intensifies and Prime Minister Justin Trudeau grapples with plummeting polls and waning public support, one cannot help but ponder the ultimate question. Can Trudeau effectively address the concerns that have led to this decline in popularity, or is he destined to face an uphill battle come election time? The critique from Pierre Poilievre raises important issues regarding the economic, environmental, and social policies implemented during Trudeau's 8-year term. The multifaceted challenges, from the carbon tax to public safety failures, underscore the complexities of governance. Now, as the nation stands at crossroads, the critical question remains, will Trudeau find a way to resonate with the electorate and secure their trust, or is his political future at a crossroads? The unfolding chapters in Canadian politics promise an intriguing narrative, leaving citizens and observers alike to ponder the trajectory of the nation and the fate of its leadership. Canadians are getting frustrated, and who can blame them? It's becoming a struggle to keep up with basic needs, putting food on the table, and having a stable roof over our heads. This housing crisis is hitting hard, making the dream of owning a home feel like a distant fantasy. It's not just about paying the bills, it's affecting the essentials, like having enough to eat. More Canadians are turning to food banks because the money isn't stretching far enough. We're stuck in this loop of working hard but getting nowhere. Trudeau's in charge, and the feeling is that he's not really getting what it's like for the average Canadian. This frustration isn't just a few isolated voices, it's a collective feeling. Your neighbor, your coworker, everyone's feeling it. As Canadians, we're not just asking for a little relief, we're asking for a leader who gets it. Someone who understands that we're not just stats on a paper, but real people trying to make a go of it in this crazy world. Trudeau, are you up for the challenge? The clock's ticking, and people are watching. Well, that's all for now. Do you think Poilievre's criticisms are justified? Could time really be up for Trudeau after 8 long years? Let us know what you think in the comments below. And if you haven't, please subscribe and leave a like for this video. Your support helps us continue our work. You can also follow us on Twitter, where we post stuff we can't post on YouTube. You can find the link in the description below. Thanks again for your support, and I will see you in the next one.